Parents, I want to talk to you about the negative and some positive effects of social media on teens and tweens. This is a report. My name is Josh Oakes, and I travel the country teaching students how to positively shine online. Now, it should come to no surprise that from iPhones to TVs to laptops, it's easy to get carried away with screen time. More and more students are reporting issues with sleep, depression, anxiety, and the fear of missing out, FOMO. This video is to help parents learn more and start a dialogue with your students, not against your students. We're going to show you some real tools in this video on how to work with them. Now, here's what the BBC says. Social media addiction is a mental health problem. Excessive usage is linked to relationship problems, worse academic achievement, and less participation in offline communities. Sounds really negative, but I promise there's going to be a little bit of positivity here. The American Academy of Pediatrics has warned about the potential for negative effects of social media in young kids and teens, including cyberbullying, says Forbes. Now, I've got the four C's of social media, the tipping point, as I call it. On your left is the good side of social. Now, the good side is when we connect with others and we make friends, and that when we communicate with them. That could be in Instagram, in the direct messages, in the DMs, because that's when we're texting, emailing, and direct messaging. Basically, hey, do you want to come to this event? Communicating, making friends, and so on. Within reason, you need to know, your parents need to know who you're making friends with. The bad side is social, and the time when I find in my life that I want to take a social media detox for a week, which is a really good thing, is when it consumes all my time. That means I'm sitting at the bank, or you could be somewhere and you just natively want to pick up your phone by default and scroll through your feed. If you students want to watch Snapchats when you're bored, or if it fills all of your time with Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, whatever your age. And then it leads to us comparing ourselves to others. So the bad side of social, the tipping point, if you will, is we need to keep it on the good side and not go over to the consuming and comparing. All right, more negative effects. The Child Mind Institute says survey results found that Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram all led to increased feelings of depression, anxiety, poor body image, and loneliness. Now, UNICEF says too much passive use of social media, just browsing posts, right, the consuming, if you will, can be unhealthy and has been linked to feelings of envy, inadequacy, and less satisfaction with life. Studies have even suggested that it can lead to ADHD symptoms, depression, anxiety, sleep, right? So the good side versus the bad side, that tipping point. Now, there's a recent report examines the positive and negative effects of social media on people's health, mostly the youth, including a list of social media platforms according to their impact on their mental health. Now, here's some stats. 91% of 16 to 24-year-olds use the internet for social networking. That's pretty clear, right? Social media use is linked with increased rates of anxiety, depression, and poor sleep, and it has been described as more addictive than cigarettes and alcohol. Now, the best and worst apps for teens' mental health. The best are YouTube and Twitter, they say. Maybe YouTube you can learn a little bit on, and Twitter you can interact, but Instagram and Snapchat are the ones with that feed that you generally are going through and comparing yourself to others. That's why you have to be really, really careful. Next also is Facebook seems to be pretty good according to this organization. Now, parents, I want to take a moment. If you're looking for the brighter side of social, we have a phone consultation or a strategy session. You can schedule a free version of that and get some safety tips, mental health, goal setting, building a positive social media presence. I'm going to show you at the end of this video a spreadsheet that we make with every family so that you can set out your sleep, school, and then screen time at the end. And it's beautiful. It's awesome. And then a website opportunity to build websites, all kinds of cool stuff. So all you have to do is fill out that consultation. I think there's a link below. You can go to smartsocial.com. Okay. It's 100% free to talk with us. Potential negative effects of social media. This is what the report says. Anxiety and depression. And you can click the links below to go to that report. Sleep, body image, cyberbullying, FOMO, fear of missing out. These are some of the negative effects. But as you know, we also have a free webinar. Not to throw too many free resources in here, but how to navigate the negative effects of students' social media. It's 100% free. It's really more like a lesson. You can click the links below. It's a webinar and top 7 bad apps, all kinds of great stuff. Free for you. potential positive effects of social media, access to expert health info if you have any problems, emotional support if you're going through a tough time, community building, self-expression, building upon relationships, and my favorite, branding your student and yourself and building a portfolio of activities and projects based around your reputation that you want colleges and future employers to see. Okay, what age should a student be on social media? This is one of my favorite questions. First, 0 to 13, you should be 100% private. We should not be able to Google your kid and find out where they're at, where they go, and who their friends are, and all that stuff. But at 12, approaching the end of the privatization mode, at 12, it's time to have a family discussion regarding what your student's online brand should look like. Way before you give them a car, you show them what good driving is because they're driving with you. And so you need to have that discussion before the age of 13, and then they sign a social media contract, physical signature, so that you're treating them like an adult, in our opinion. And age 13 to 15, build a personal portfolio and start putting positive volunteer photos online. We do this with students, that consultation talks about it. Then get on Instagram as an extension of the personal brand. That's important. Age 14 to 15, inside of that, it's time to start looking at publishing the portfolio as a website so it improves your students' Google results so that by the age of 17, colleges will be able to find a positive online footprint for your student. This is a bit of a deep dive, but it's super, super important with when should my student start to be on social media, less from an addiction standpoint and more from let's shine online. You see, this is a positive video. I'm arguing for the benefits of Instagram in a way. Parents, you got to be with your kids. Now, when should I give my kids a cell phone? The kids aren't going to like this. Our professional suggestion is 0 to 10, no phone. You don't need a phone 0 to 10. My opinion, but it's pretty accurate. If you must have a phone from 10 to 13, if you must, it's a flip phone. You can text, you can call people. That's communicating, coordinating, all kinds of different stuff, and connecting with people, right? SMS and text. But at the age of 13, it's time for a family cell phone contract, a signed contract saying, I know who pays for this, I know what the replacement cost is, I know it could go wrong, and I know how it's gonna get taken away. Age 14 is a smartphone without social media apps installed, right? And that's training wheels. Basically, I'm gonna give you a golf cart, let you drive it around the golf course before you get put in that Ford with real keys on a real road. And that's a smartphone, training wheels with no social media apps. Next is 15 with social media apps. You get your smartphone and so on. That's important. This is take a screenshot, pause this. Good. Kids don't love it, but it lets kids be kids a little bit longer. All right, what can parents do? Start a dialogue early and often about social with your kids at a young age. Talk regularly, fill out our consultation page. We'll help you do that. Ensure your children are equipped with the relevant skills to be able to navigate social media. Lead by example and model your positive behaviors for your child. Remind your children they can always come to you or a trusted adult if they ever need, if they see something or they need help and something's awkward online. Wait until your kid has shown that they can handle the responsibility of using social media before letting them set up your first profile. Also, be on all the same apps as them. Now, remember, I've got a free webinar. You can click the links below. I hope you'll join me. And I want to thank you guys for joining me on this video, but I want to show you also just really quickly, if you set up a consultation with us, right, on the front of smartsocial.com, you're going to see big buttons, schedule a free consultation, parents and educators as well. We talk with people all over the world. And if you set up a consultation and we end up working together, we're going to develop a screen time plan for your family. We build this all out. How much sleep? Okay, and the student works with us. We fill out the green zones and chores and homework and studies. We fill out the good stuff above the fold, and whatever's left over, we have time for video games and screen time. So it's life-changing. Rather than saying, don't get on your screen, instead we say, what do you want to fill your day with, right? This is all interactive. And as it changes, this is really cool. Do you want to do 4 hours of homework a night? Watch on the right-hand side. Boom, it changes. And that's what's really neat, is this is all interactive. We build it out for your family. Next, we plan out your students' messaging in a document, and we build out a little portfolio. These are private. You can do private portfolios so that when your student is ready and your family is ready, they become public. Gerard's Passion Projects Public Service. These are home run, old school. We are old school, old fashioned people that work hard to build a positive brand. There's no cheating. It's all about, here's all the projects I've worked on. Jasmine's a wonderful example. Here's her roller coaster project that she actually videoed and put online and worked hard to mousetrap. I mean, she's a STEM education future engineer. Couldn't be more proud of this young woman. Building rockets. I mean, she's taking the good stuff she does in real life and she puts it on her website so that rather than you saying, tell me about yourself and why do you want to come to this college? She goes, look, let me show you. These are the things I do. I mean, this young woman, she got into her dream school. She's got an amazing, amazing scholarship. And I'm not saying it's because of the website, but according to her principal, it was a big part of that. There's all kinds of different things. She's got her passion, her projects, her public service, and so on as well, internships. So I hope you'll take the next step. I hope you click the buttons below to learn more about how you can work with us. I'm Josh Oakes, talking about the negative effects of social media for teens. Also, you can pick up one of our books, my latest book being the orange one in the back, teaching teens and professionals how to shine online. Guys, thanks so much for joining me. Give me a like, a thumbs up. Go listen to our podcast to learn more. You can click some of the links above or below. Give me a thumbs up and tag somebody below who might find this interesting. Thanks so much for your help, guys. Have a great day. I'll see you soon.